Green Baptist Academy,
we will be performing Charlie's Aunt by Brandon Thomas.
I can't get to the heart of this. I don't know what to say. Don't know how to begin. I wish to goodness I'd spoken to her at the party the other evening. Well, they told me they were going away for the summer. But instead I've gone and left it all until the last minute. And now, I'm regularly nonplussed. By George, I know what I'll do. I'll make an exercise of it. I'll write it out a dozen different ways and send the one I think looks the best. So, come on, Jack. Here we are, in love with the dearest girl on earth. Face her like a man, and tell her so. That'll be off to Scotland, and you'll be gone on holiday, and you'll have lost your chance forever. So here goes. My darling. No, rather strong. Perhaps to begin with, my dear Miss Verdun. No, too formal. None of it what I really feel. My dear... Oh, why not? My dear Kitty...
I say!
Oh, confound it! I wasn't addressing you! Go away! Oh, it's you, Charlie. I thought you were brassed. Oh, what is it, old chap?
Nothing, Jack. I don't want to interrupt you.
Oh, Charlie, don't go. It's only that idiot Brassett was bothering me.
What's he doing?
Only bagging all my clothes because I'm off on holiday and worrying me like old Harry while I'm trying to write a most important letter. Oh, don't mind me today. I'm nervous and naggy and non-blue.
So am I, Jack.
Well, what?
I'm trying to write a letter, too.
A letter? To whom?
Well, to Miss Bettigew.
Well, how far have you gone?
Oh, I mean, it awfully well, but I didn't want to be too distant. And I didn't want to be too... well, too...
familiar? Well?
So I just said, my dear Amy. And then words failed me. I've come to you for advice. You always know what to say, Amy.
Oh, do I?
You know my idiotic complaint. I'm shy. You're not.
Aren't I?
It's so prescribed for me, old chap. What am I to say?
A good idea. I'll prescribe for him and take the medicine myself. Now then, you're in love with Amy Spettigue, wish to know if there's any hope for you. And if so...
You see, they're all off to Scotland tomorrow.
Oh, yes, I know. And you wish to see her at once. Do I write the case accurately?
To a T, old chap.
Very well. You'll want to say something to this... My dear Kitty.
No, not Kitty, Amy.
Yes, that's right. What was I thinking of? My dearest Amy, forgive me, darling, for thus addressing you, but I love you so deeply. Underlined.
Rather strong, Jack.
Shut up. So earnestly. Also, underlined,
I say
that I must write and tell you, sir. All I ask...
But there's one obstacle to my putting it quite as straight as that. As much as I'd like to.
Well, what's that?
Well, I'm an aunt.
Oh, well, my dear Charlie, most of us have. What about her?
Well, I feel I ought to tell her first.
Oh, well, if you're going to drag an aunt into the business, we may as well wait till they all get back from Scotland.
Why?
You know what auntie is when she steps in.
No, I don't. That's just it. I don't know her. I've never even seen her.
Well, you won't be too hard on that aunt. She hasn't interfered in your affairs much, up to now.
Except to find out that I was an orphan and had been sent to Eton and to Oxford. And now, my guardian writes to me and tells me that she'll be arriving this morning by an early train and will take lunch with me at 1 o'clock!
And you've never seen her?
No. She went out to Brazil before I was born and became a sort of secretary to a very rich old Brazilian chap out there called Don Pedro de Alvadores. And now, by the merest accident in the world, I found this!
Madam, or rather, Dona Lucia de Alvadores, the Brazilian millionaire who has taken a magnificent mansion in Belgravia, is an English woman and a financial genius. Indeed, it was her capacity in this direction that earned the gratitude of her late husband and led to a romantic deathbed marriage. But I don't see much in that.
Go on, Jack, read the next.
Her only relation is a nephew at Oxford. Lucky nephew.
That's me.
By George, Charlie! This is the startler! And she will be here any minute!
I'm not all the trains up to now! Oh, I wish she'd have come some other day.
She'll arrive by the next! Just in time for lunch!
Yes, it's a bore. I wanted to write that letter to Amy.
Well, I don't know so much about that.
But it's an awfully difficult letter to write. Fearfully complicated.
Why?
Well, you see, I have no people or anything.
No people? With an aunt like that?
But I have no reason to expect anything from her. More than what she's already done for me. For which, of course, I'm very grateful and all that. But I wanted to write that letter to Amy and put it to her that it's...
Johnny! I've got a clicking good idea!
Jack, you are a good chap. You write it down and I'll copy it out.
No, not for you. For me. For us both. You're gone on Amy and I'm in love with Kitty.
Really, Jack?
Badly. Worse than anything I've ever taken up. Even cricket. I was writing to Tanner, sir, when you came in. There's the letter. Oh,
Jack, I'm so glad. What's your idea?
Hanging letter writing. We'll have lunch if you want. Tea afterwards, in the garden.
In the garden?
Yes, I'll get tea.
But my rooms are so small.
Never mind, I'll lend you mine. Now come on. First, we'll ask the girls.
Ask the girls?
To meet your aunt.
Do you think they'll come?
They'll jump at.
Oh, what makes you think so?
Well, what do you think?
Why, Jack, you know, I'd rather agree with you.
We'll send it on at once. You read it. Go on. My dear Miss Spettigue.
Yes, Jack, I've got that.
Would you and Miss Verdun do me the honor?
The honor?
To dine with me and Mr. Chesney.
Mr. Chesney?
I'll address the group.
I'll address...
No, not that, you muff! At his rooms, St. Olds College, today at 1 o'clock. Miss Spettigue.
Miss...
No, look out! To meet my aunt, what did you say your name was?
Dona Lucia de Alvadores.
Yes, Dona Lucia. All right, sit down. An answer by bearer will greatly oblige.
Yours sincerely, Charles Wickham. Splendid, Jack, you're a genius!
Yes, it's a glorious opportunity. They're off to Scotland.
And we're off on holiday.
Yes, we shall have them all to ourselves. This sort of thing is not to be settled by correspondence.
No, and we shall have them all to ourselves.
We couldn't have asked the girls if it hadn't been for your aunt. I'm beginning to love that dear old lady already. Now, when you and Auntie are off observing the chapels and the cloisters, Kitty and I can have our little talk.
Yes, Jack, that's all very well, but what about Amy and me and our little talk? My aunt will be in our way horribly.
Oh, I hadn't thought of that.
My aunt's all very well as an excuse to get the girls to come here, but by herself she'll be an awful bore.
She'll be worse than that. She'll be a brute of a nuisance.
Oh, what shall we do?
Well, Napoleon's been over the Alps on horseback, and I've been under them by train, so there must be a way out of this.
Yes, can we ask someone?
Someone we can depend on.
Yes, but whom?
I've got it! Babs! We'll ask Babbity to entertain you all this.
Yes! Why don't we think of him before? By George, Jack, you'll be Prime Minister one of these days.